Hi guys, myself Hima, a first year BSc psychology student from ISSA College. First of all, I'm sorry because I feel a kind of fear. I'm tensed to talk in front of you. Hey guys, do you have a kind of fear or are you scary about anything? If yes, do we have any psychological disorders like any phobias? So, I'm gonna talk about phobias with the help of an article written by Kendra Cherry. She's a well-known psychosocial rehabilitation specialist, educator, and speaker. She has published thousands of articles on diverse topics of psychology, including child therapy, personality, research methods, intelligence, and much more. As a psychosocial rehabilitation specialist, Kendra utilized behavioral, cognitive, and socialization strategies to help the young clients to cope their family interactions, peer interactions, aggression, social skills, and academic difficulties. So yeah, let's come to phobia. Phobias are one of the most common mental illness of United States. The National Institute of Mental Health suggests that 8% of US adults have some type of phobias. Women are most likely to experience phobias than men. Typical symptoms of phobias can include nausea, trembling, rapid heartbeat, feeling of unreality, and being preoccupied with the fear object. The American Psychiatric Association, that is APA, identifies three different categories of phobias: social phobias, agoraphobia, and specific phobia. When people talk about having a phobia of a specific object, such as snakes, spiders, or needles, they are referring to a specific phobia. So have a look to the four major specific phobia categories. While not comprehensive, this phobia list offers a glimpse of many phobias that can have a serious impact on a person's life. As you may notice, while you browse through this list, a more specific phobias fall into one of the four major categories: fear of natural environment, fear related to animals, fears related to medical treatment or issues, fear related to specific situations. One important thing to remember is that virtually an object can become a fear object. The names of specific phobias are often formed as nouns, words, or words coined for a single occasion only. These names themselves are often formed by taking a Greek prefix that represents the fear object and adding the suffix phobia. Because of this, any attempt at a completely exhaustive list of phobias would simply be an exercise in futility. Any list of phobias could grow with the addition of newly coined terms for previously unnamed specific phobias. While listing all of the phobias that may exist is not possible, it can be helpful to look through a list of some of the most commonly described phobias. As you can see by looking at this list, almost any object or situations become the source of fear. Phobias can have a serious impact on well-being, but it is important to remember that you are not alone. Phobias are common but also treatable. If you believe that you have the symptoms of some type of phobia, consult your doctor for further evaluation and treatment advice. So yeah, hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye.